And just welcome to everybody for what will be probably our final service, certainly in church this year, 2020. We'll be glad to get rid of 2020, won't we? Formalities before we start, just make sure that your name is on the list at the back. On your way out, there's some gel to dry your hands. I don't think there's anything else, is there, that I need to say? No? Wardens? No? Okay, so I suspect that some of you might have come today with a little bit, a few mixed emotions, especially after last night's, or yesterday afternoon's, announcements. So you might be here this evening, hearts kind of etched with feelings of loss, maybe sadness, disappointment, frustration, worry, anxiety. These are all very genuine, real emotions. Our plans have once again been changed, haven't they? And we're now facing Christmas like no other. However, one thing does remain certain. Our plans have changed, but God's plans have not changed. God's plans have not changed. They remain steadfast, and that's the hope we've got, isn't it, to hold on to, that He has got a plan for our world. He has got plans for each one of us here tonight. And one of those plans that He had was sending His Son down, Jesus, down to the earth. So that's really who we're celebrating tonight, as always, but more so, I think, because of the time of year it is. And it wasn't a last minute plan. He didn't just suddenly think, oh, what should I do? Oh yeah, I know, I'll just send my son down to earth. It was a plan that was very, very carefully thought out, very carefully executed plan. A plan to save His people. A plan to ensure that we can find a way of one day being in heaven with Him. And we read about it, don't we, in the Old Testament, the prophecies that were made. Isaiah 9:6, for to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on His shoulders, and He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. And then John 3, verse 16, for God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whoever believes in Him shall not perish but have eternal life. In both of those passages, there's an emphasis on the word give. Isaiah, for a child, a son is given to us. And in John, for God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son. It's a gift. Jesus was a gift given to us from heaven, from God. A gift that wasn't hastily given. A lot of planning went into this. And I just feel like today that there's a lot of people in this world who have at one time or another received this gift in the past, and they unwrapped it, and it wasn't an unwelcome gift, not an unwanted gift, and yet they've reached a point in their lives where they no longer feel the need for it anymore. It's almost like they've wrapped it back up and then just pushed it somewhere in the back of the cupboard. And just forgotten about it, a forgotten gift. During the first lockdown, you might have seen on social media, there was a poster going around which said, no movies, no concert, no sporting events, no restaurants, no social gatherings, limited workload. And then it said, now that I've cleared your schedule, can we talk now? Signed, God. I thought that was quite poignant, really. And I feel we've kind of come a bit full circle with Christmas, with all the plans that have just been shattered. I just feel like God's saying to us, go to that cupboard, get out that gift, unwrap it again, and just receive the gift of Jesus once again. And I've cleared your schedule, therefore you have got time to spend with Him this Christmas. To spend Christmas with Jesus. Have that quality time with Him. So tonight, as we just listen to the songs, the carols, just kind of clear all your thoughts of all the rubbish that's going on outside these walls, and just focus on God. Just focus on Him again. So let's just pray. Lord, we've cleared our schedules to be here tonight. We've come this evening into your presence to spend time with you, to be reminded of the love you have for each one of us. So through the words of the songs and carols, we remember your birth, your coming. We remember how the glory spread around. And Lord, we just pray that tonight your glory will fill this place again, despite us being few in number. We just want to feel you close to us. Just a chance to be intimate with you again, Lord. So Lord, be with each one of us now. Amen. So just sit back, relax. Well, you don't have to just sit, you can stand and dance around if you wish. There's no restrictions on that, is it?
well during the evening, or mince pies, so just feel free to eat and drink whenever you feel free. And just one more thing, the words on the screen for the carols might not quite match the words we're singing. There's that many variations, but you know it's inside out anyway. So.
Oh, you dancing, maybe this one will.
Thank you.
worshipped here. I was reminded earlier of a song that we used to sing, probably children at school to be fair, but we might have sung it here, isn't it? Which is, what can I give to the King? So it's Christmas time, we receive gifts, but we also give gifts back. So just want you to like focus on what is it that we can give back to Jesus this Christmas. What can I give to the King? Give to the one who has everything. What can I give? What gift can I bring? What can I give to the King? What can I give to the King? And then the answer. Give him a heart that's opened up wide. Give him a life that's got nothing to hide. Give him a love that's tender and true. And the reason for this, the carol goes on to say, because he'll give it all back to you. Yes, he'll give it all back to you. So what can I give to the King? Give to the one who has everything. What can I give? What gift can I bring? What can I give to the King? Give him all glory, his people are there. Give him all praises, this time of his birth. Give him all honour in all that we do, as he's given his life to you. Yes, he's given his life to you.
Thank you.
you know, just seeing the blessing over you, but just our heartfelt thanks be to for coming tonight and just being with us and sharing the experience with us. I think we've all really missed not being able to be here for all the different carol services over Christmas. But we do still wish you all the joy that Christmas brings, and just spend time with families if you can, safely over the phone if not. But God's blessings with you, each one and every one of you. God bless you all.
Thank you. by the saving grace today. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with us all evermore.